I've been using an app called Endel for the last couple of years, and it's pretty crazy what it can do. We're going to review whether Endel is right for you, because it is a wild experience. It uses neuroscience to help create soundscapes for you, and uses AI to help make them better. So we're going to give you my review on whether Endel is worth it in today's video. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesco. If you're interested in joining Toolfinder for reviews, insights, and to explore more deals, you can find it linked below. It's free to join and you can come on board today. If you're interested in a deal on Endel, you can also find it linked below too. Now, Endel comes as a strange pricing. It always seems to change whenever I go on it. I think it's because it's adaptive pricing, but I found it for $2.99 a month. And it does have a yearly pricing if you did want to. The application comes on a range of different devices. It's actually got pretty cool access to things like Alexa, Google Home, Apple Watch. There's so much on the website, it's pretty intense. And I actually use the Mac app and the iOS app, and I wanted to talk about the Mac app first. So very simply, it allows you on Mac to do focus, relax, and sleep on the premium modes. Obviously, some of those soundscapes are locked when you naturally have each of your different or you're on the free plan. There is an ability to tune each of them to be intense, structured, easy, and fluid per soundscape, and you can choose a range of different ones in the focus mode, like dynamic focus, study, and deeper focus, which are collaborations with other people. Relax, and there's a range of them for relax, recovery, spatial orbit, natural, and wiggly wisdom, which is a favorite of mine, as well as sleep, wind down, hibernation, AI lullaby, and rain, which are all designed for better sleep. Now, inside the Mac app, it pops up on the Mac menu bar and allows you to use scenarios. So for example, you can use binaural beats, deep work, read, and set a timer for those, as well as a custom timer, which can be used for the Pomodoro system. But the idea behind this all is a range of different things. Circadian rhythm combined with input and data, as well as attributes like location, weather, and health data as well. So for example, circadian rhythm's telling me that the midday energy rise is here, and I'll peak in 26 minutes. So I might want to choose the autoplay that will help me choose the best environment for my focus. And this might help you to better take breaks across your day, and also seeing recharge and rise when your circadian rhythm changes across the day. It picks up information like when you woke up, what's your current heart rate, what's the weather in your location, and helps put together a recommended structure for the day and designs and generates each soundscape based on those attributes, which is pretty cool. Now, on the mobile version, there's some really decent abilities. For example, on mobile, I can actually access the ADHD upgrade, which allows you to use colored noise, binaural beats, I don't know whether I'm saying that right, and also a blocker, which blocks apps that you're using. There's been a focus timer for some time on there now, but it's much better on iOS, and the range of different experiences for sound is really good. So what's my actual experience of using the sound? I've been using Endel for probably 2 or 3 years. I use it for sleep and I use it for focus. They're probably the two environments that I most go into. But I also like the relaxation tape, which is Wiggly Wisdom. Now sleep, I pretty much turn this on and fall asleep straight away. Now I wouldn't say this is like an endorsement of it, but it's probably because I've associated with that track so much with my sleep. But I do find that I'd probably sleep a lot deeper and struggle to sleep without it. But maybe that's because I've created the actual habit of having that in place every time I go to sleep. So at the same time, it's a weird placebo for me, or at least I find that I've gotten into so much of a habit of using it that it's probably causing a better experience for me. The same with focus. I really like how the focus experience works. Some days I do find that it works really well. Like I get into a really strange state of work, and then an hour and a half later, I'm like, whoa, maybe I should take a break. But some other days I turn it on and I don't get that engagement. And that might be something to do with neuroscience, or it might just be the fact that I'm working and some days I won't be focused. So thank you very much. I hope this video was helpful in helping you choose whether Endel's right for you. Please do let us know in the comments below whether you went for it, and we'll do an in-depth review in a few months to check out whether they've added some new features. Thank you very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.